Let's do an example together using file input and output. And so I'll create a new file, public class file IO example. Fun. Okay. Public static void main string args. And the purpose of this program will be to read in a file and to print out the file backwards. This is going to be a very useful program that I'm sure will sell millions of copies. We're going to read in a file and then print it out backwards. Okay? Now, I don't mean backwards like the first letter, the last letter first, but in words. So we're going to read in one word at a time and then we're going to print it out backwards. Okay, so in order to do this, we're going to need to import a couple of classes. One, we're going to need to import the java.io.file class to be able to read in from the file, right? We're going to need to import the java.util scanner class to build the scanner to attach to the file. We're going to need to import the java.io.printWriter class to write out, and then we know we're going to need to import the java.io.file.not_found exception, which we've run now we've run into now a few times. I'm telling you, it is warm. What you need to do is just to play along with me. Turn up the temperature in your room to about 90 degrees, and you'll be where I'm at. So what we want to do is let's get a file to read in. In fact, I'll leave it up to the user. I'll ask them for the file. So I'm going to create a string variable called file name, and I'll set it equal to blank to begin with. And then I'm going to ask the user, system.out.println, please enter the name of the file. I'll concatenate so I don't run onto the next line. You want to print out backwards. Okay, and then they'll enter that in. So file name equals, and I don't have my scanner built, so I'll come up here and build my scanner. Scanner in equals new scanner system.in. So in dot next line will give me the path of the file name, right? Now I come to a little dilemma here, because in order to create the file, I'll practice good habits here. So we're going to get the file name from the user to build the file object. Okay. What I normally would want to do here is, in order to build the file, I would normally say file f equals new file and then the file name. Now I'm leaving that up to the user to enter correctly, but I don't like the fact that I'm declaring something down in the middle of the program. And so again, I think we've mentioned this before, but we can declare this up at the top. Just file f, give it its name, and then down here we can set it. And that way it keeps everything kind of declared in one group up at the top, very easy to find if we need to make changes there. And then we just reference that object and set it down here in the body of the code. Okay? So now I've got that file name set up. Now I need to attach the scanner to it. But again, normally I would say file in equals new scanner that's attached to this F file. But I don't want to do that there. I'll do that up here and call it scanner file in. Down here, I'll just refer to that file or that object. And I'll put a little comment in here that says build the file and attach a scanner to it. Okay, so there's what we're doing there. We build the file based on the file name that was entered, and then we attach the scanner to it. Okay, so now we've got the file that we're ready to go through and build. Now, printing out backwards is complicated because we know we can't just go back and access the last word. We have to access the words in the order that they're coming in the file, right? And so that presents a problem. So what do we do to solve that problem? Well, this is where we can kind of tie in some other things that we've talked about in the course. One of them is arrays, because if we put this every word into an array, then it will be really easy to go access the last element of the array and then print out the rest. And maybe I made that too easy. I should have let you think about the situation for a minute. How can we solve that problem? Well, do we know how many words are going to be in the file that they type in? We don't, and so we want the file that we're accessing, or sorry, well, the file that we're accessing, we want the words that come in to define the size of the file, but we don't know how many words. And so there are a couple ways we could go about this now that I'm just thinking about this. Now, this is all on the fly. I should pre-plan this stuff. So forgive me if I'm not coming up with the best ideas right off the bat. But on the other hand, I think it's kind of helpful to walk through the process of how do we actually get there. One thing I know I can do already is go do a word count. And then once I have the word count, no, that still wouldn't help me. I could do it, but it'd be very ugly that way. Oh no, I knew what I was thinking in the first place. You could, after you had the word count, then you could build an array of that size and then read it into a regular array. But we do have the array list type, which allows us to dynamically add an element to the array. So we just keep adding and adding and adding, and it keeps attaching. And so the array is as big as it needs to be, one element at a time. And so I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to build an array list. And the types are going to be strings, obviously. So I'm going to build a string array list and call it the words. And that's going to be equal to a new array list of the string type. Okay? Now it's going to yell at me here and say it cannot find the symbol. Oh, and I'm missing my parentheses here on the end for building that type of object. So it cannot find that symbol. So I need to go into the import from the Java, I believe it's the util library, and import the array list type class. Okay, so now we get another error saying unreported exception. Once again, I'm trying to build a scanner, sorry, build a file, and that file and that directory may or may not exist. And because I can get a file not found exception, I should probably take all of this non-defining code and put it into a try catch. So I'll grab the try there, I'll indent everything to show that it's inside that try. And then I'll come down and put my closing brace, and then below that I'll catch the file not found exception. And then system.out.println. Sorry, invalid file. Okay, so now I'm catching that exception, and if I run this program, now it will work because I've imported the ArrayList class and I've imported the, or sorry, I've included the try catch. All right. This reminds me of a random story, but it's so hot in my office. What I'm thinking about is the place where I've been in some hot places. The place I think that it was the hottest I've ever been was my sister and brother-in-law moved out to Chicago. And so I went out to Chicago with them, and as we were driving, we stopped somewhere in Iowa for a picnic. And as we were at that picnic, and this is years back when there was like the heat index was like, 100 and 15, and the you know, cows were dying all over the place and stuff because it was so hot. And so we stopped off for a picnic. We got in some shade there and had our little picnic of sandwiches on the road to take a little rest after all the driving we'd done. We were in a this rental truck that could only do 55 miles an hour about, unless we got really close to the semi in front of us, and then we could get up to about 65 or so. So that was torture. But even more torture was because there was a car driving along with us. So the car had to kind of stay with the truck, and knowing that you could go that much faster in the car was torture as well. Anyway, we stopped off for this picnic, and as we're sitting there, this tanker truck pulls up, and it's kind of making a funny noise. And then it starts smoking. The guy pulls over to the side of the road, and these huge, big tanks of looked like fuel tanks were on this trailer. And the guy got out, and this tire had exploded, and there had been some sparks, and the truck was starting on fire. And so smoke starts coming up, and then a few, not too much longer later, all of a sudden the gas tank explodes, just this big boom. And then the gas tank on the other side, boom, and that explodes. And so then we're getting kind of scared because we're only like a half a mile away from this thing, and there are these big tanks on the back of the truck, which the fire is now approaching. And so we just sat there and waited and just were like, man, this is going to be really loud. My sister's covering her little baby's ears, and we're kind of wondering if we should run for shelter. Anyway, the tanks just burned. They never did explode. And so as we drove out, we found out it was carrying gravel. I don't know why it was in that type of a tank, but it was carrying gravel, and the thing was cooked crisp, melted all the way down. There was nothing they could do. And that driver was walking away shaking his head at how annoyed he was that his truck just burned up to the ground. But that's how I'm feeling right now, because then we went and moved him in this crazy heat in Chicago, and it was really, really hot, really bad. And then after we got done moving them in, about 3 or 4 months later, we went to go visit them in the winter, and it was as cold as I've ever been in Chicago. I couldn't believe how do people live there when it's so hot, miserably hot, and so miserably cold? I don't know. Anyway, that's what I'm feeling like, and I don't know why I just went into that random story, but it's hot in here. Have I mentioned that? Okay. Well, I've now made it so that I have to go into a second video, and so let's go ahead and continue on in this next video with this example about setting up the file to print out backwards. Spencer out.